हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल youtube.com/doctorvet। वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग हियर द वेटरनरी साइंस एंड एनिमल हस्बेंड्री लेक्चर्स। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर हेड। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी कवर ए इम्पॉर्टेंट डिजीज, डायबिटीज मेलिटस इन डॉग्स एंड कैट्स। इन पार्ट थ्री we cover details of clinical findings of important endocrine disease, the diabetes mellitus in dogs and cats. Friends, here we see details of clinical signs of diabetes mellitus in dogs and cats. Friends, the onset of diabetes is frequently insidious, means it is gradually progressing. It may take over weeks or months to develop sign. The disease proceeding in a very gradual and subtle way, that it is difficult to analyze or describe the disease. But slowly progressing to a serious condition and may produce very harmful effects. The disease has got chronic clinical course. Here the characteristic is osmotic diuresis due to hyperglycemia, increased glucose level of the blood, and that causes osmotic diuresis. Result is the polyuria and glycosuria. Continuation of the clinical signs. Here we see an important mechanism of osmotic diuresis because it is a characteristic of the disease. The glucose is not that easily reabsorbed from the renal tubules. The glucose is retained in the lumen of the renal tubules, and that result in osmotic pressure of the renal fluid, that is urine, and that is the osmotic diuresis. That results into the polyuria and glycosuria. There is hyperglycemia in diabetic ketoacidosis, and that results the osmotic diuresis. That result into severe fluid and electrolyte deficit. The cases become slowly serious and worsen. If the animal is untreated, left untreated, then it causes a severe fluid deficit and may cause a severe condition, acute renal failure. Friends, we have seen the common things that happen to develop the clinical signs and various stages of the clinical signs. Now here onward, we will see very common clinical signs. Polyuria, that is the increased formation of the urine, and that result increased frequency of the urination. That is because of the osmotic diuresis. Polydipsia, because of the polyuria, there is compensatory increased thirst, and animal wishes to take more water because of the dehydration. Polyphagia, there is increased food consumption, that is because of the disturbance of glucose metabolism. Weight loss is observed. Increased food consumption, but there is loss of body weight. But some dogs and cats manifest decreased appetite depending upon the type of etiology of the diabetes mellitus. Friends, we continue with the common clinical signs, and main two disorders of the lens are observed, that is the cataract and swelling of lens. Frequently, cataracts is observed in dog but not in cat. Cataract is bilateral and mainly due to metabolism of glucose in lens, because glucose is everywhere increased in the aqueous and vitreous fluid of the eye, that result into increased glucose level in the lens also, and that withdraws the fluid and causes edema of the lens, that causes cataract and disturbance of normal light transmission. Mostly it causes a partial blindness in the dog. The other disorder of lens is swelling of lens. There is increased concentration of glucose in aqueous and vitreous humor of the eye in diabetes mellitus. The glucose penetrates into the lens of the eye, leads to entry of water into the lens fibers, and that causes a swelling of the lens. Continue with the common clinical signs of diabetes mellitus. There is great weakness because of the lack of energy, especially muscles. Some cases, chiefly in cats, there is diabetic neuropathy, degeneration of the nervous system. It is observed that in case of diabetes mellitus, there is a decreased resistance to bacterial and fungal infection. So the case suffering from diabetes mellitus invite infection. The decreased resistance is due to decreased chemotactic, phagocytic, and antimicrobial activity along with decreased neutrophil function, that decreases the resistance and invite a recurrent or chronic infection. In the field cases, it is observed that there are suppurative cystitis, prostatitis, bronchopneumonia and dermatitis cases are commonly observed in diabetes mellitus cases. Continue with the clinical signs. Hepatomegaly is observed, enlargement of the liver. Clinician can palpate the abdomen and may feel hepatomegaly. The hepatomegaly is due to either cirrhosis and mostly due to accumulation of fat. The fatty liver is observed. That is due to increased fat mobilization from adipose tissue into the liver cells, and the fat deposition into the liver cell called a condition fatty liver. There is a chronic renal disease also, we have already seen. Infection, at the same time acute renal failure. Blindness is also observed due to cataract and due to microangiopathy. In various parts of the body, the gangrene is also observed due to two reasons: microangiopathy, decreased resistance, and when glucose is there, there are more chances of establishment of the infection. Continue with the clinical signs. Slowly the disease progresses to a more serious condition. There is accumulation of ketone bodies in the blood, loss of sodium through urine, hydrogen plus is conserved, and that results into acidosis, and slowly there is a severe metabolic disorder. The case goes out of control. Up till now there is compensation, but as the disease progresses, it turns to a decompensated diabetes mellitus case, which is a serious condition. The animal reaches to a coma stage. Initially, simple diabetes mellitus case slowly progressed to a more severe condition, that is decompensated diabetes mellitus. There are two forms. One is the diabetic ketoacidosis called DKA, and the other is hyperosmolar hyperglycemic state, that is called as HHS. Difference between these two is that in diabetic ketoacidosis, there is ketoacidosis and hyperglycemia both. Both things are occurring, ketoacidosis and hyperglycemia. While in HHS, hyperosmolar hyperglycemic state, the hyperglycemia is more severe than DKA. But in HHS, there is no ketoacidosis. This is the difference between these two. We will see the details of these two in the subsequent slide presentation. Sometime mixed form of both DKA and HSS also occur. That is more severe case. In this, there is severe hyperosmolality combined with ketoacidosis. So that is the serious condition. Now here we see diabetic ketoacidosis, form of decompensated diabetes mellitus. It is characterized by two things: ketoacidosis and hyperglycemia. Now we see here the mechanism of diabetic ketoacidosis, and that results due to three type of abnormalities. First is the insulin deficiency, either absolute or relative insulin deficiency. The second is increased insulin counter regulatory hormone that works against insulin. These hormones are cortisol, glucagon, growth hormone, and catecholamines. The third abnormality is peripheral insulin resistance, that is type 2 diabetes, that we have already seen in previous videos. We continue here the mechanism of diabetes ketoacidosis. We have seen three abnormalities. Due to that three abnormalities, the cell cannot access glucose. So what cells do? Cells use free fatty acids as energy source. These free fatty acids are broken down into keto acids. The result is keto acids and glucose accumulate in the blood, and that leads to ketoacidosis case. This causes a severe metabolic disorder. These metabolic disorders are very deep and sometimes life-threatening. In the next presentation, we will see which are the metabolic disorders. In the previous presentation, we have seen that there is severe metabolic disorder in diabetes ketoacidosis case. For a clinician to know this is very important, because clinician has to provide diagnosis and treatment of the case. Here we see which are the metabolic disturbances. Dehydration because of the osmotic diuresis, that result into hypovolemia, decreased blood pressure, increased glucose concentration of blood, hyperglycemia. There is increased gap of the anion group of the blood, metabolic acidosis, severe electrolyte imbalances, and other. In the next presentation, we will see. Continue with the metabolic disturbances in diabetic ketoacidosis. In previous presentation, we have seen 6 or 7 metabolic disturbances. Continue here. There is azotemia, elevation of liver enzymes in serum because liver is affected, hyperlactatemia, there is development of clinical signs, that is vomiting and anorexia, and vomiting and anorexia also develops particular clinical signs. So clinician has to give treatment in such severe cases. The clinician has to give the treatment to reduce production of ketone bodies and establishment of euglycemia, that is normoglycemia. So clinician is required to correct the rehydration and giving short and long acting insulins. The detail of the treatment we'll see when we'll see the treatment aspect. Friends, we know that there are two types of decompensated diabetes mellitus. One is DKA and other is hyperosmolar hyperglycemic state, that is HHS. In DKA diabetic ketoacidosis, there is hyperglycemia and ketoacidosis. In HSS here, there is severe hyperglycemia but no ketoacidosis. This is the difference between DKA and HHS. This is a syndrome of decompensated diabetes mellitus. In this HSS, there is profound hyperglycemia. So it increases hyperosmolality and cause more severe condition. Here the pH is normal. There is no ketonemia or ketonuria or acidosis, but there is severe hyperglycemia. Friends, in this video, we have discussed the clinical findings. Requested to share this information to veterinarians and veterinary students. To promote the channel, subscribe the channel, press bell icon so that you can get regular notification. If you like this video, press like button. Thank you very much for observing this video. Next time we'll come with diagnosis and treatment aspect of diabetes mellitus in dogs and cats. Thanks.